Namaste. Greetings to all dear teachers from Password Publishing House Limited. This is Vinesh K. Menon. Today I will be sharing my ideas about importance of pre-writing activities. When kids come to our school, especially to kindergarten classes, they are not coming to learn something. They are coming to the school just to play and to celebrate. Students of LKG, especially, when they come to the school, they will find it very difficult to adjust with the situation. There will be cries and other tantrums for 2-3 weeks. So teachers will be finding it difficult, also finding it difficult to cope up with the situation, to get them attached to the hearts of the teachers. So at that time, it is not advised to give them pencil and book or slate to write and practice. It is not advised to insist them to sit at some place and to repeat something and to learn. And most of the people, most of us are having an idea that learning is what we give or what we see them writing. Learning is not simply writing. Writing is something that they have learned, and what they are having in their mind or brain as an image, they are simply copying that image using some instrument like a pencil. So to hold the pencil itself, a lot of other things are needed to be achieved, like their pencil holding capacity, finger strength, hand-eye coordination. For all these fine motor skills, some activities are necessarily needed. They are doing something from their birth to up to 4 years at their home, some kind of activities, and they are getting developed with these fine motor skills. But once if it is not developed properly, that level of development has not been achieved, they will be finding it difficult to write and to learn in the classes. So we teachers should of course give some pre-writing activities. So pre-writing activities or pre-learning activities are meant for developing their fine motor skills and also improving their hand-eye coordination. So I will be telling some of the activities that could be given at home with the guidance of the parent before they hold a pencil and write something in the notebook or in the textbook. Students are amazed. They are so happy and excited to draw pictures. You may have seen students drawing pictures on the wall. They may draw a family, they may draw their home, the picture of a flower, and simply draw some lines on the walls. And always parents get irritated, they may get angry after seeing this, the paintings or drawings on the well painted wall, colorful walls. But it's their nature. They have that inborn tendency to take something and to draw on a platform, on a surface. So this is how they develop their fine motor skill. So if it is given with the guidance, then that could be connected, easily connected to their learning curriculum. Scribbling is a wonderful pre-learning activity. So teachers and of course parents can give them opportunity to scribble. You can give crayons, because crayons are their first tool of learning. And that crayons are colorful. That makes your world colorful. Wherever they draw, they can see some colors. And colors are the first thing that they get attracted towards. So scribbling using crayons should be the first activity. And there should not be any kind of instruction. There should not be any kind of pattern. Let them scribble on whichever with the surface we are giving using the crayons. Newspaper could be given for scribbling. Your children can scribble on the newspaper using different crayons. Any kind of patterns could be given for scribbling, like standing lines. So they can scribble from left to right like this. And they can scribble standing lines from top to bottom. They can go for zigzag lines like this, again from left to right. The direction should be given properly. They can go for curves, left curves, right curves, up curves, down curves. They can go for circles. So the circles also can be from left to right. The direction that you are suggesting, that you are making them to follow, should be continued. Then you can ask them to copy some circles into a paper or into some other surface, maybe on the newspaper, no problem. So copying circles, so they can simply draw some circles. So all these are different ways of scribbling. Why I am telling newspaper is the best place to scribble is because that scribbled newspaper could be used for some other activity. You can ask your child to tear newspaper. That should be done every day. All these activities should be done every day. Once if you are giving some activity for one day, then don't expect that all the fine motors have been, the skills have been developed properly within a day, and the next day your children would be taking a pencil and write everything neatly and perfectly. It's not like that. So all these activities could be given for one term, maybe up to 3 months in LKG. So at least the parents can give such activities every day for 1 month. Take 10 minutes or for 5 minutes for doing this, or 15 minutes for doing this. So tearing newspaper into small pieces. These bits of papers, the newspapers, could be used for some other activity. You can draw some patterns, big patterns on a paper, in a book, and ask your children to glue that bits of paper inside the pattern. It's like you can put the glue and ask them to paste it, that's enough. But they have to paste it inside the boundary, so that they have to be a little bit careful. They should give more attention. That hand-eye coordination should be proper. So such an activity also could be given. Now, take a tray of sand or some other dry material. Make your child to draw patterns or lines using the finger on inside in the sand. You can take any kind of dry powder. So students also already learned the letters, can write letters on sand. That is also some good activity that gives proper stimulation for brain development. As I said, students are so happy to paint or to draw pictures. You can see, sometimes you may have seen students standing in front of a wall and drawing pictures like this. So they draw pictures or they scribble on the wall within the height of their body. They may not be doing like this on the top, or may not be on the bottom part, but they can do it correctly according to their height. So that could be appreciated. Once, if you paste a chart paper or an A4 size or A3 size paper on the wall and ask, give your child a crayon to draw pictures, so he can do it. This activity will definitely improve their hand strength of holding a crayon or a pencil. Students are happy to lay down on their tummy and to draw pictures or paint using crayons. That activity also could be appreciated. That also could be given. Another one, you can take Ziploc bags. Just fill it partially with some jelly-like material. Close it, spread it. Then instruct your child to draw lines on the bag. Then they can see lines are forming, or the patterns are forming on this bag surface. When they press it, this jelly material moves apart and the line gets formed. This formation, when they see it, they get wondered. So standing line, sleeping line, slanting line, curves, circles, all these patterns and shapes could be drawn. So that is another activity, pre-learning, pre-writing activity. Again, give them a painting brush and some water. Ask them to paint on the floor. Just to dip that brush in water and paint on the floor. So once, if they are doing it, they also think, they may think that there is no color. They are painting but no color. But the parent can take it in another way, that when they can get express the feeling of amazement, and they can say, wow, it's beautiful. So you are painting beautiful on the floor. So your children will take it and accept it as an appreciation. They will continue doing it. Since they are doing it on the floor, that will in no way that is going to affect you. Okay, so that is also a wonderful activity for children. And cutting vegetables in different shapes, and allow your children to eat that vegetable. So you can take a cake cutter or children's scissors and ask them to cut the vegetables in different shapes and patterns. If it is like cucumber, they can eat it. The vegetable like cucumber could be eaten raw. So that activity, you can take that leaves of a cabbage and ask them to cut it. That also could be eaten raw. If it is lady's finger also, they can cut it into small pieces and they can eat it. So cutting vegetables, or sometimes you can take clay or play-doh. You can buy it from the market, play-doh or clay, and that could be formed into different shapes. So your children would be using both hands to do it, to squeeze it, to pull it apart, to roll it, to make different shapes, to make lines or to make letters. So that is a wonderful activity. So for their improving their pre-writing, improving their fine motor skill, and at last, whatever be the activities or whatever be the household chores that you are giving, then so that your children can do it with both the hands, that will definitely improve their fine motor skills. Buttoning and unbuttoning. The child can button his or her father's shirt, unbutton it, put the zip and undo it, plait, threads, anything that could be done in their age using their hands could be used as an activity for improving their hand-eye coordination and also for developing their fine motor skill. All these activities could be given for UKG students also. But when it comes to UKG students, all these activities could be connected to what they have learned. They have learned all the alphabets from A to Z. So while scribbling, let them scribble alphabet. While cutting vegetables, let them cut vegetables in the form of alphabet or in the form of numbers. When they take vegetables, please ask them to count it and take it. If they are taking onions, ask them to count it. So counting activity also could be done. If they do Play-Doh activities, then let them form letters and numbers using the Play-Doh or clay. Even parents can draw some patterns on the floor, like not simply patterns but the alphabets or numbers on the floor, and ask your children to ride bicycle along that letter or the number. And you can ask your child to make the sound of the letter, to read the letter, that say the name of the letter, and also to make the sound of the letter and to say some words that begin with that sound. So that can be a revision and also can be an activity for gross motor skill and also for fine motor skill. And again, if you are giving them crayons to paint or to draw pictures, tell them to draw the picture of alphabet. From A to Z, they can draw the alphabet in different colors using the crayons, like one letter in one page. So in a notebook, if they take 26 pages, will be consisting of colorful alphabet from A to Z. One page colorful A's, the other page colorful B's, then colorful C's, like that. They can take a newspaper, then they can cut the picture of bikes, two wheelers. So that's, we call it bike. That begins with the sound B. So let them paste all the pictures in a book and write on the top letter B. So B makes a sound B and B for bikes. So bikes. So that is an activity and also it's a learning practice. So like this, whichever be the activities that I told you for LKG, pre-writing activities that could be given for UKG. If a mother and son or a daughter sit together and play revising this alphabet, then things will be fine. So your children should feel like a play or a game. It should not be like a learning time. Then they will be finding it very difficult. If a mother asks her child to close his or her eyes, and the mother writes a letter on the back or on the hand, and then tell the child to identify the letter and read it. If your child has already learned the letter, the alphabet, and the image of the letter is in her brain, definitely your child can say it. So that is again an activity. A mother can prepare 26 letter cards, drop the letter cards on the floor, and mother can say a word like apple, and tell your child, UKG child, to take the card for the first letter sound. So apple, R is for the letter A. So child has to find out the letter A card. So that is also a game. So all these kind of activities could be given for LKG and UKG children before they start their lessons. In the textbook, LKG textbook, from 7 to 12, the pages are meant for tracing strokes or lines. Before a parent make his or her child to do it at home, all these pre-writing activities could be given so that the child can hold the pencil properly and trace the strokes. And in UKG also, first two pages are meant for revision of alphabet. So, or if the teachers give a proper training to the parents in front of teacher from A to Z, parents can give parents can do that revision at their homes. So with this, let me conclude. And we will see again with more interesting activities and learning methods in kindergarten later in some other video. Till then, bye. Thank you.